Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to Let's Play Fallout New Vegas, where we're outside the infested bunker. So-called infested bunker. We seem to be missing a Veronica. I don't really know how or when that happened, frankly, but we seem to be missing a Veronica. There's myself, there's Rex, there's Russell, and there's Cass. We seem to be short one power-armored punching machine. I'm not entirely sure how that happened. Now that I think about it, she was conspicuously absent earlier when I was handing out rifles and things. No, I think she was there, actually. She'll probably turn up once we enter the new area. I hope so anyway, but she's clearly disappeared on her own little errand of some description, so, I mean, whatever. I'm not a dictator. She can do what she wants. It's just a little bit irritating. She immediately disappears as soon as we're about to enter the infested bunker, where someone wearing power armor and punching things would be actually, you know, reasonably useful, if I'm honest, really, because there's going to be a lot of close quarters combat in here, but never mind. What can you do? Russell, this is the one time, by the way, that I will permit you to use the knife. Not that me permitting you or not permitting you makes any difference, frankly, most of the time, but hey-ho. Also, you may have noticed... Bootface? Yeah, nice. Bootface. Awesome. You may have noticed... My voice sounds different. I've got a new microphone. It sounds pretty good, if I do say so myself. It sounds really nice. This is apparently what £250 and a lot of fucking patience will buy you these days. So, yeah. There you go. This is the microphone I was talking about in, I think, the previous video that I was going to be getting. And you will notice that if I go into the menu here and I click my mouse a whole bunch, you should not... I mean... It'd be kind of funny if you could hear that now, actually, but you should not be able to hear me clicking my mouse or tapping my keys or doing anything of the sort, which is grand news, grand news. Yes. I even did the ultimate stress test, and I recorded about a minute of F1 2016 with full force feedback on my steering wheel, which normally was so loud you couldn't hear my voice properly in the background using the old microphone. But now it seems to work. I'm not going to say that the steering wheel is completely silent in the video, but you can barely just hear it clicking away every now and again in the background, but it's completely manageable and doable now. It's a huge difference. It's a huge difference. It's a headset microphone, obviously, now is what I'm using. So I strap it to my head along with my my earphones. And it works that way, so I can lean back in my chair, I can turn to the right, I can turn to the left in my seat. It doesn't matter which direction I'm facing. You guys can still hear me crystal clear, I hope. Which means I also don't have to have this huge, ridiculous microphone boom arm towering over me all the time on my desk. So I can actually see my left-hand monitor a lot more clearly now. All of a sudden, I also have an absolute shitload of desk space free now to put things on and whatever. It's truly wonderful. But anyway, enough gabbing about that. It sort of speaks for itself. No pun intended. Alright, you two can stop looking at me like that. Fine, whatever. Okay, flechette rounds are equipped. Shotgun is at the ready. We have a Rex, we have a Cass, we have a Russell. I think these giant rad scorpions are thoroughly fucked, if you ask me. They don't stand a chance. Let's do this. It's a quick save anyway, though, because I'm not completely foolhardy. I may also depends how dark it is in here, but I may require either night vision or the torch. I'm going to opt for the torch if I can, because the night vision's a little bit... Oh, there she is. There you go. I see you went ahead to scout out. That's what you were doing, Veronica. Fair enough. All right. Flashlight. This will do for now. And hello. There they go with the knife again. Russell, you madman. You know, if you want to take on the giant rad scorpions that look really, really squished and optical illusion-y, what the fuck is that about? Look at that! Ooh. Crimson scorpions. Sounds like a gang name, but no, they're literally crimson scorpions. A horrible vial of crimson scorpion squeezins. You decline to reminisce on the actions you took to procure this vial of squeezins. I'd rather not, thanks. They're not worth that much. Also, my flashlight apparently is going into rave mode over here. That's all very nice. So what do we got? Big old bunker, lots of NCR signs, corpse over there. With an interesting looking hat. posters, all the usual stuff. Wow, yeah. I need to change the batteries in this thing or something, because goddamn. Hello. What do you have for me? 12 gauge rounds, stim pack, currency, hunting shotgun, dog tag, ranger patrol armor, and ranger patrol headgear. Oh, it's not like you were going to be using it, was it? You know, I'm just going to go ahead and turn that off and use this instead for now. It's a bit distracting otherwise. What's the deal with this? Aside from it looking badass, I mean. Alright, we pissed something off. It's the ghost of the NCR Ranger. It's sort of a gas mask, cowboy hat, NCR helmet combo. Funny I could remove the badge. I like this. I like this. This is David Crumpington kitted out for biological warfare. It's perfect. Oh, it's so... It's. I mean, hopefully it gives me perception plus one. So I'd still need to carry the gas mask around if I want actual radiation resistance. But, DT3... Got two ranger helmets for some reason. When did I pick up the second one? Whatever. Question is... Oh no, it doesn't do night vision! Oh, that sucks! Unbelievable! That would have been perfect! It doesn't do night vision or give me any kind of radiation resistance. It just looks cool. I might have to, you know, I honest to God might have to go into the construction set that, you know, the GEC and do something about that because that's just not on. I can't leave this behind. It looks too badass. I mean, I kind of wish the NCR badge wasn't on the helmet, but I mean, on the hat there, but. Imagine if I turned up at Chola Mountain wearing this thing. We're taking this with us. As for the armor, well, you know, it counts as a disguise or whatever, so it's problematic, even though it does obviously look kind of cool, and again, it would be nice if I could have my own personalized version of this with all the logos removed and shit. Because that does look cool. I mean, that looks really cool. The DT-15... It's actually the same as my fancy saloon attire, which has been impeccably armored with Kevlar plates and whatnot, don't you know? It just is, okay? You can take my word for it. Even looks good with the duffel bag. Well, I'll be damned. Yeah, this would be like my I mean fucking business, and I ain't gonna take any shit from any ghouls and stuff. Armor. It feels very Wasteland, actually, as in Wasteland 2. To be fair. Man, that's cool. You know what, we have to take this with us. We have to. I don't care if it's technically a disguise or whatever. Yeah, it's coming with us. I just need to find a way to carry it. Well, I guess I've got the duffel bag, haven't I, right? Gives me a slight... Stat decrease the duffel bag, sadly, but, heck, it's there for a reason. So we'll use it. What else we got then? 12 gauge rounds. A reloading bench. Lots of cases of... Oh, ammo casings. Oh, I mean lots. Holy crap. Thank you very much. What else we got? A toolbox. With a few things in it that are probably useful, but honestly, I can't remember what they're useful for. Oh, that's useful though. Rough, indeed, Rex. Same to you. All right, well, let's go in further. Can we use the intercom? Anything behind here? Yeah, you're not happy about something, are you, Rex? Uh-oh. What are you doing, buddy? What are you doing?
What the fuck?
You hear nothing. Except the sounds of combat and screaming and death. Get away from my dog. Oh, damn it. There we go. Well done. Well done. You're not just not in the mood today, Cass. Is that what's going on here? You fed up. You figured, well, I shot enough dudes outside, it's fine. Hello. More stuff. I'm just gonna grab that because I wanna repair it. I'm so annoyed that doesn't have night vision or anything like that. And it's probably gonna be a pain to try and apply night vision to that in the construction set, if I'm honest. At the very least, I can give it a radiation bonus. Hmm. Atomic cocktail. Oh, why not? Some whiskey for you there, Cass, if you fancy it. Alright, so far so good. So this was some sort of ranger bunker previously. Evidently. No shit, Sherlock. I'm gonna run out of flesh out rounds pretty quickly at this rate. This is a fancy looking door though. Question is, where is it going to take us? With a loading screen this long. We have a radio, which I'm probably going to have to destroy, and oh god, here we go. Some sort of underground facility.
Guess you won the lottery.
Oh, don't talk about the lottery, seriously.
Time for some getting.
Alright, everyone sure, run in front of my fucking... I can't tell which ones of these are alive still. Jesus Christ. Rex, my dude. I genuinely... It's a big writhing mass of... Holy crap. Some of these are big. Rex, how are you not dead, dude, after all that? I swear. Oh my god, I leveled up! Really? I think I still need to kill... I'm not gonna grab all these poison glands. I'm just not gonna bother. Too many of them, and they do actually have a significant bit of weight to them, so... We grabbed a few, it's fine. Bags. They always have good things in them. Gotta love a good duffel bag. Right. Yeah. These are really big rad scorpions. Like, I have never seen rad scorpions this big kind of rad scorpions. Sweet Jesus! No!
Six this bitch.
You're more than six it. Alright, right, right. Come on. How do I charge this thing up? That's how- Whoa, hello. It's a shame most of them are already dead by that point, but... Any excuse to use the green laser of death is a good one, if you ask me. Well, that would be Big Bertha, I suppose. She's got neon lights on her and everything. I was kind of hoping for something special on you. Oh well. Big Bertha's dead. Along with all her children. Well, not quite all of them. I have a feeling there's probably more. And this place looks huge, so... can anyone pick this open? Russell, maybe? Russell! Very poor. Alright, never mind. Forget I said anything. What about Cass? Very poor. And... Oh, okay, never mind. Level up time. Well, what do we fancy? What do we fancy? Something that allow me to craft nice things would be nice, I suppose. Barter's always good, of course, as well. Explosives, guns. I've already got loads of guns and energy weapons and stuff as well, so. And an arm's not bad either. So I could bump that up to a nice even 70. But 70 is an odd number, Dave. Shut your face. No, it's not, actually. You can divide it by... Oh, whatever, never mind. Maths. Maths. Repair? Yes, actually. Just fuckload of repair, why not? Junk rounds. Survival is the mother of invention. Craft ammo at the reloading bench using alternate metals. Or materials, scrap metal and tin cans. Could be useful. Nerves of steel. With the Nerves of Steel perk, you regenerate action points much more quickly than you normally would. Lessons learned. The Wasteland has taught some hard lessons, but you've remembered them all. You gain plus 1% to earned experience per level gained. For example, plus 25% experience at level 25. I'm trying to wrap my head around that one. That basically just make us level up faster, right? Do I really want to level up faster? I don't know. You level up to get perks, so why get a perk that just makes you level up faster? It's a waste of a perk, right? Kinda. That's very... You know what, I'm gonna take that right now. Because I'm running into a lot of enemies that I'm shooting in the face with this shotgun, and they are just not taking damage because, you know... Because of the damage threshold. So you know what? Bit of a dull perk, but I'm going to take it anyway because I'm sick of shooting things in the face with a shotgun and them not dying. Well... How long do I really want to stick around here? Could be an interesting place, but at the same time, I just want to... I want to get out in the open air, honestly. I'm sick of places like this at the moment. We've got a lot of ground to cover, you know, and I'm not doing a lot of that while I'm sitting around here. In a bunker with lots of dead people around. Although, I will be having some of this. Very nice. I don't know what we're gonna use these dog tags for. I suppose we could probably hand them over at some point to somebody. So I might as well keep picking them up. Hello, ammunition boxes with surprisingly little stuff in them. Disappointingly little stuff in them. Goodness me. That's a lot of primer and powder. Lead! Oh, yes! Okay. Right. Now we're in business. Really, that was all I could make? For heaven's sake. Oh, I need a lot more lead. Anything I could break down that's a bit useless to me right now? Break that down. Break that down. And that. If I accidentally been making ammo instead of breaking it down, I'm an idiot. But you already knew that, so... No harm done. Alright. Guess a slug or two? Three away rounds as well. There we go. Alright, okay, we made some more ammunition. Good. Begin to wonder if maybe I should get that junk ammo thing. I guess the junk ammo probably doesn't do as much damage though, does it? Either that, or my weapon condition will suffer from it. Oh my goodness me. Okay, right. This was clearly like a little ammo factory they had down here. They were making lots of ammunition in this place. Big time. Well, thanks for all the fish, as they say. I do wonder what was behind that very hard locked door, but we're probably not going to find out anytime soon, sadly. Oh dear. Hello. There, see, I got some kills this time. You guys didn't steal them all. Not that I should really complain. I still get the experience from it, and it doesn't cost me ammunition. So, come on, the footlocker's empty anyway. As is this one. Duffel bags never let you down, do they? Look at that. Oh, doctor's bags. A cowboy repeater. Flame of fuel. Microfusion cells. Oh my. Oh my, oh my. I'm not going mad here, okay? Duffel bags always have the best shit in them. They just do. It seems to be one of those weird laws of the universe. I am duffel bag, therefore I contain all of the nice things. Alright. This looks like potentially where the rad scorpions tunneled their way in from. Oh, hello. Oh, hello. Armory key. Oh, a detonator. Another G36. And more of these. Fucking Christ. Ranger Sequoia. Hello. Alright, we don't need you then. Oops. How do I drop you? There we go, that's how. Okay. We've got two Ranger helmets at the minute. Let's have a third. And I'll tell you why. I will tell you for why. It is being in case the time ever arises where we need to go out and kick some serious ass. And I will equip all of you guys, with the exclusion of Veronica, because she's already armed to the teeth, with the best armor and guns and things I can find, and I'll give you all night vision helmets and all that kind of bullshit, and we'll do some Black Ops nonsense. Should the occasion ever arise, and, you know, the way some of these human bounties, at least, are going lately, I'm beginning to think that day might come. So, we'll carry a few of these around. I could repair a few of them, but since I'm not really going to be using them, I mean, I've got one for me, and I don't care what condition it is in, really, because generally speaking, I just use it for the night vision, and I got another two. So that's fine. I just need to... I can get rid of... No. Get rid of the surgical mask. I need a... Oh my goodness me. Repair at least a few of these, I guess. There you go. Now we got two better quality ones. Oh yes, and the Ranger Sequoia. This is like my hunting revolver, but better. I like it. It has incredibly rare ammunition, but I like it. Damage 55. Hell yes. However, we do still have that. Right, anyway. Right, okay. Well, you know, that's about... Aside from the armory, which we now have a key for... God bless you, universe. You're just... Everything's coming up crumpeting right now. It's beautiful. Aside from the armory, that's about it. Hello! Hello, armory. Armory is such a wonderful word. It's possibly my favorite word in the English language, it has to be said. You're locked in here with the key. How did you die? Maybe you got shot and then crawled in here and locked yourself in. NCR Captain's Terminal. Can I get into that, I wonder? Won't worry about that for now. Goggles, helmet, and a ranger hat. Maybe not. It's a bit disappointing. I mean, it stands to reason, perhaps. Okay, fine, yeah, they raided the armory prior to this place getting attacked by giant rad scorpions. Alright, fine, but, ugh. After going through all that effort to find the goddamn key, I expected better. I really did. Alright, can I get into this, or can I? Or am I going to have to get Veronica to do it? Ugh, dear me. Alright. You power-armored lunatic, come over here. Anyone bring a pack of cards? Oh! Veronica, thank you very much. Alright, what do we got? Squad testing! General Lee Oliver, Camp McCarran to Albert Petro Mojave Bunker. Spelled incorrectly. Squad testing. Be on the lookout for any more unusually gifted troops. After we lucked out with that psychic, the president himself thinks we can start putting these quasi-mutants to better use. He wants us to start assembling a team of such individuals for use on special missions. Crocker is over at Camp Golf inspecting the latest batch of recruits over there. With any luck, we may even find a solution to the whole Legion problem right on our own doorstep. Oh, great. So we got a bunch of MK Ultra men who stare at goats thing going on. Okay. Here's a list of petite people you may be interested in. Lara Atkinson, private, recent recruit, athletics expert, and already one of our top snipers. Arnold Bull, aka Bulldozer, very strong, very high pain threshold on legendary kill count. Wade Guerra, ranger veteran, one of our most intelligent and experienced rangers, knows the local area better than anyone else posted here. And Paul Hickman, physically unimposing but performed to an outstanding level on all audio tests and has proven to be a great scout. I'll have them sent over to McCarran first thing in the morning. R.E. Bull. After the testing phase, we've decided only to keep Bulldozer. Only he has been informed of the purpose of the tests. The others were curious too, so make sure no one else finds out what this has been about. X-13 MIA. It's been nearly a day since we last heard back from our X-13 troops. Their last reported location was the emergency rail yard station east of Prim. Send word to any troops in the local area to perform a recon. Oh, let me just see that again. Oh, damn it. Emergency rail yard station east of Prim. Okay. Mental note, folks. Mental note. Either because, oh, there's a bunch of very well-equipped troops that went missing over there, so they might have cool stuff, but also a bunch of very well-equipped troops were presumably killed by something in that rail yard station, so maybe we should just stay clear, because it's whatever it is, it's not worth it. Urgent respond. What the hell is going on over there? We have not received a single communication from the Mojave Bunker in over 2 days. Has there been an attack? We need a status report immediately. Yes, Bertha happened, I'm afraid. There she is. Big, beautiful Bertha. Well, it's been lovely. It's been truly wonderful chilling with you wonderful rad scorpions. You are just such lovely people. Oh, is this the cafeteria? Yeah, I do believe it is. The heck? Crunchy mud fruit, why not? Fresh potatoes? Aye, to be sure. Mutt fruit. Am I really over-encumbered right now? I am, oh my goodness me. I'm not sure what I'm going to use this detonator for. Do you think it's... It's just occurred to me that there might actually be some explosives around here somewhere that will explode when I pull this detonator trigger. Well, you know what they say, curiosity did kill the cat. But satisfaction brought it right back. Okay, well, you know what? We're not dead, so... Why, what's wrong with Rex? Aside from the fact that he's bouncing up and down on the spot like that. But aside from that, what is wrong with Rex? Do we have a clue? I don't know. Anyway. Oh, right. Oh, this is in full condition anyway. Alright, well. See ya! Can I move again? I can, hooray! Alright guys, let's get the hell out of here. I've had quite enough of dingy, dark, horrible bunkers for quite some time now. Just you wait. Randall's next contract will be in a dingy, dark, horrible bunker. Calling it right now. Just a hunch. Call it a hunch.